Hey Ospreys, I'm Katie Guile, your UNF cinephile. This week I'm talking to you all about the new installation to the horror franchise, Paranormal Activity 4. Well friends, I can tell you that if you're a fan of easy thrills and the no longer surprising element of surprise that's synonymous with this series, you'll enjoy it. If you're looking for substance, decent writing, an actual story climax, or plot, run screaming before the movie starts. As in each Paranormal Activity film, this one establishes an interesting tech-savvy means to record the nighttime creepery. This time, it's with the aid of MacBook cameras and an Xbox 360's tracking dots. When something goes boo in the night, the glowing green dots capture the movement in night vision. With the exception of this interesting twist, which I'm sure the Mythbreakers and Ghost Hunters will all have lots of fun with, Paranormal Activity 4 played the same tricks each movie has. The tension built throughout the course of the movie works to bring you to the edge of your seat, and if you suspend your disbelief, it's a good bit of fun. But if you're looking for subtlety or anything that'll stick with you, this isn't it. In an attempt to create a movie that tied loose ends from Paranormal Activity 2 with a plot line, including the child who went missing, this movie fails pathetically with no addition to the plot. And it breaks from the tradition of the past movies when it blithely skirts over the plot undercurrent of the past three movies that includes a coven. However, Paranormal Activity 4 continues the grand tradition of documentary-style actors. In attempt to appear realistic, the performances are stilted and awkward at best. In that way, they fit the movie well and I'm sure fit the bill, but the movie was altogether unfortunate. If you like the franchise and want some good, tense screams, you'll enjoy the movie. It's not the strongest of the bunch by any means, but it will make you jump. Paranormal Activity 4 earns its one star for the grab a hold of your seat screams. It's in this that it succeeds, if nothing else. Thanks for watching. I'm Katie Guile, and I'll see you next week for another healthy dose of celluloid.